Good morning, students. Welcome back to the next session of Artificial Intelligence. Well, today we are going to see a different aspect on probabilistic reasoning. Like, for example, previously, whatever the probability or the probabilistic reasoning, whatever you have learned, is how the static nature. So today we are going to see the dynamic aspects of the probabilistic reasoning. Let us take one example here. For example, one car is there, and this car got damaged because of some reasons. Now, the reasons to damage the car are evidence. Okay, the reasons for damaging the car are what the evidence. Now, what happened is that, for example, if you are finding the probability of the condition of car, so like condition of car, like the state of the car, if I'm representing as S, what I'm representing the state of car as S, and the evidence I'm just putting as E, okay, so now, what we are going to find out is probability of state of car given set of evidence. Okay, E here is what the set of evidence. So now what happens here is that, why I'm saying this as a static example? Why? Because even after some time or even after some days, the state of the car will not going to be get changed. Over a period of time, the state remains in the same way. I mean, if the car is damaged at particular time t1, after time t1 passes, that at time t2 also, the car state doesn't get changed. That means whatever the damage happened to that car will remain same at time t2 also. So what do you mean by this? It means that this is how the static nature of the probabilistic reasoning. But you know, there are many examples where all the examples will not satisfy the static property, okay? They will be in dynamic nature. What they are in? Dynamic in nature. That means the state of the probability will going to be get changed at time t1, and after that time t2, it will not the same as like as t1. That means t1 will not be equal to T2, okay, because of having its dynamic property. Now, for that, if I'll take an example, like if I'm treating a diabetic patient, this is how an example where I'm taking for to get to know the dynamic aspect of the probability. So, if I'm treating, if a patient is get treated, okay, by diabetes, I mean, if a patient is suffering from diabetes and there is a need of treatment, what is going to happen here is that, for example, the sugar level, the sugar level at particular time t1 will be some value, okay, will be x value as x. But after some time, at time t2, the same value will not be as x. It will going to be get changed. Okay, and X will not be equal to Y because of many other reasons. Why? Because, for example, even after some time also, it will going to be changed. The impact will be based on the food intake. That means if a patient consume food, what happens? The value Y will get increases. That means Y will be greater than X. Okay, and at some times, the Y value will get decreases to X. So that means Y and X will not remain same. Okay? So such kind of problems, where if I'm finding the probability in order to treat a diabetic patient, I cannot say that the value at time T1 and at the value at the time T2 will be same. No, they will not be same. So such kind of problems where a change is, where a dynamic nature has been implemented over there, that means probabilistic values will be changed over a period of time, okay? then that in order to handle such that kind of things will be handled by a concept called as temporal model. What the model is? Temporal model. So this temporal model will going to handle such kind of things. That means what it handles the dynamic aspect of the values of probabilities of particular variable. I mean the x will be the set of different values. X is a set of different values over a period of time. So this is how a temporal model is implemented in order to handle such kind of things here. Okay, so now we are going to the actual concept here. So that's why you can get to know why there is a need of temporal model. It's because the first reason which I said you just now is that, like, whatever we have learned till now is how we learn a static world concept. Okay, that means whatever the random variable, if I consider them as x at time t1, okay, has some fixed value. That means even after a t2, it will not be going to be changed. It will be x only. So that's why it has a fixed value. Okay, and the same example is there here. Like if I want to repair a car, and if I want to know the status of a car over a period of time, the status of the car doesn't get changed. Okay, it remains what? Fixed. What it remains as? Fixed. Okay, but there are some other scenarios. Like I have given an example to treat a diabetic patient. What is going to happen in diabetic patient is that the insulin doses, for example, if you give insulin, apart from the food, if I give insulin to a patient, a diabetic patient, okay, what happens? The sugar level get decreases, right? So the insulin, the amount of insulin also matters here, and the insulin doses also matters here. And if I take, if a patient take more food or less food, so the food intake also plays a factor which get changed the value of, the sugar value, sugar level. Okay, so the blood sugar measurements will always, will depends on many other things such as this insulin doses or the food, whatever the patient intakes, and the physical symptoms, whatever the patients might have. Okay, so all of these things are the factors will make a patient to have a random blood sugar. That means the blood sugar will not be constant, it will be in random order. So what is our concern is that, what is our requirement is that we have to access the current state of the patient. For example, at particular time t1, I want to access the value of x. This x is what? The blood sugar of the patient, okay, at time t1. It can be also insulin level, okay. So in that case, we are finding. So what we have to do is that at particular information, we need to decide, okay, that based on this value at that particular time, we have to decide that what amount of food has to be intake and what amount of the insulin has to be given to the patient. Okay, but what happens in the case of car repairing, okay, the dynamic aspects will not be there. So these dynamic aspects are essential if this kind of problem, like treating a diabetic patient. So what happened? Why? Because there will be a change rapidly over time. Okay. And because of the factors which I just now said. Okay. So all these are depends on that. So in order to handle such kind of things, what we require is temporal model. Okay. And this current state will not just depend on the existing value. It can be also from the history of evidence. I mean, how long the patient is suffering from diabetes. Okay, that is also matters here. And what was the sugar level previously from the last 3 months or 4 months. Okay, so that will be helpful to predict the outcome of treatment actions. That means what this temporal model will handle the current state. Okay, it will handle the current state also by taking into consideration the previous information, the history. Okay, given evidence of history. and the actual value, current value. So based on that, the current state will be determined. And remember, the current state value will not be the fixed one here. Only the current state is to handle the particular amount of time, what can be the value, that value will be handled here. Okay, that's why we are taking such kind of model. The name itself indicates temporal model, means the current state is not fixed, as if it's not a permanent. The current state will going to be get changed at some amount of time t2. If the, at time t1, if the value is x, at time t2, the value won't be x, it can be the value y. So the change in the value will make the model as a temporal model. That's why the name itself we have given as temporal model here. So that's the reason why the temporal model mostly are being used for dynamic aspects, okay, to handle such kind of dynamic aspects in probabilistic reasoning. That means whatever we have learned so far right now in uncertainty or in the in with context to artificial intelligence is all about probabilistic reasoning. So now whatever we are learning right now is about the dynamic aspects of probabilistic reasoning, okay? So it means like we handles that one, okay? So what is the thing is that here, so of course what we can say, the environment is not certain. That means if it is uncertain, what happens? We have to track the current state of the environment, right? In a normal way also, if I go in the static way also, because the probabilistic reasoning is actually used to handle uncertain environments, okay? So here also the uncertain environment is there, but along with that, what is the thing is that the change in the probabilistic reasoning, the values in the probabilistic reasoning will not remain fixed. It will going to be changed over a period of time. That is one added thing in the dynamic aspects of probabilistic reasoning. So what is that here? Why we require temporal model? Why? Because the data is partial. Why I say the data is partial? Why? Because, you know, if I take the current state will let you know the current status. But I may not going to get what can be the future state or what can be the future value. So it will term as a partial data, a noisy data in some other example you can consider. So that's why what happened, because of this, the environment is uncertain. Okay, over a period of time. Okay, that means the value at one time will not have the same value at another time. So that's why we have to, what we can do right now is, we just focus on the current situation only. Okay, because we don't have complete information. We can't say that what can be happen in the future. I mean, what can be the level. Only what is that at the current situation, what is the status based on that, only we can suggest that we cannot say that after 2 months whether we should give insulin to the diabetic patient or not. Or through tablets also it can be get controlled. So the future states will not be predicted as of now. Only the current situation or the current state will determine doctor to help to treat such kind of patients. So that's why only the current state is responsible here, not the future states. So now if I take in this temporal model, basically there are two sections here. The first section is on the time and uncertainty. In that we will be discussing all of these things. Apart from that, the main thing is about inference. Okay, we'll be knowing about, because mostly in every part, inference topic will be there. Here also we are using inference concept. So before that, first we will go with the time and uncertainty. That means how the things will matters here, how the states can be prescribed, I mean like how can they be represented, and what can the problem will achieve if I describe all the states or some of the states, and how the problems can be solved. The problem can be solved by stationary process and Markov assumption. So let us see now what are those things now. So as I said that, you know, changing world. Why this is over a period of time, the probabilistic reasoning will not have the same value. That means changing world is mentioned here. As I said, random variable, I mean for every environment, we have a random variable at each point in time. So that means world will not remain the same. I mean the values at particular time t1 or at particular time t2 will not have the same value. That's why we are using the term changing world. Okay, and each point of time, that means for example, at x1, the value will be different. At x2, the value will be different. At x3, the value will be different. That means each point of time, okay? So this is associated with time t1, this is associated with time t2, and x3 is associated with time t3. That means, for example, if random variable if I'm using as x, and if I'm using time as t, that means at time t1, the random value, random variable value will be x1. And at time t2, it will be different one. So in that way, it will going to be changed, so on for the set of the time slots. So all of these things are called as time slots. What they are called as time slots. And the time slots can be, you can consider with 1 second, within some seconds, or you can consider the slots interval. What you can say as slots interval. Some minutes, some hours, some days, some months. Okay? Like if I take diabetic patient, so you can consider in some minutes, okay? After some minute, like after 30 minutes or after 60 minutes, okay? What happens? Particular slot of every slot of 30, you can consider as 60 minutes. Okay, so like if time t1 is there after passing 60 minutes, so t2 will be there, so the value will going to be remain, will change. At t3 it will be changed. So this slots interval depends on the example, depends on the scenario, okay, depend on the problem. So that's why this will be having a slot here. And because of this, what happens is that the relation among the variables, like x1 and x2, x2 and x3, will describe how the state evolves. Okay? For example, like t1 is for one particular time, after passing 60 minutes, it enters into t2. And again, t2 after passing 60 minutes, it enters into t3. So what happens, x1, after that x2 might decreases, might increases. X3 again might increases or might decreases. Let us consider the diabetic patient example only. So like at for example, if T1 is at 10 o'clock, so the value will be different. At 11 o'clock, the value might change. At X3, the value might change again. So this describes that how the pattern is following here. And because of this, what happens that the state can be evolved. That means, okay, this is how it is performing. That means the level of sugar is decreasing, okay, gradually. Or else the level of sugar is increasing gradually. Or it remains constant. Constant is in the sense like it has some mini impact, but mostly it will be the same. So it all depends. So this kind of relation will describe that how the state functions over here. So that's why I said to you that this temporal results, okay, temporal models contains what? Temporal results. What they are contain? Temporal results. So these are actually a series of snapshots. What is snapshots here? Okay, this how the random variables we have taken, right? So we will be taking this as a snapshot. So what is that here? Is this as a series of snapshot? Series of snapshot means continuously the state can change, okay? And at particular amount of time, the state can be different. And as soon as the time get changes, the state will going to be get changed further. So that's the reason, like all of this kind of information will be stored in temporal results in order to know that how the pattern has to be, pattern is following here. And here, if I say you that the snapshots are, you can term the snapshot even as time slice even. Okay? That means group of time slides or group of snapshots will let you know the temporal results. So that's why the time slides contains a set of random variables. Okay? What these are set of? Random variables. So these snapshots, okay, are time slides. The other name is time slice. So these snapshots or time slice will contain set of variables such as we have taken x1, x2, x3. So but in that some case, some examples, it will be having some states will be observable and some are not observable. So in order to go with an example, in order to explain that how the some states are observable and how some states are unobservable events. So for that, Like we are taking an example of umbrella and rain. Okay? Now, I'm taking one scenario. One security guard is there. Okay? And his duty has been appointed in the underground floor. Okay? Where he cannot see the outside environment. Okay? The security guard cannot see the outside environment, whether the rain is happening or whether the rain is not happening. Okay? But what is going to happen that whenever a rain comes, the manager, whenever he used to come in his car, he will bring what? Umbrella. Or by any sources, whenever a manager comes, he'll simply bring umbrella. So, as soon as whenever a manager brings umbrella, okay, along with him, the security guard will assume that the rain is happening or the rainfall is occurring. Only when if he brings umbrella. Rainfall happens when umbrella, if a manager bring umbrella. And if manager doesn't bring umbrella, then the security guard will assume that there is no rainfall. Outside there is no rainfall. Okay? So if you observe this here, there are two events. One is observable and one is unobservable. With respect to security guard, what is observable? Umbrella. Because what he can see here, what he can observe is umbrella. But he can't see whether the rain is happening outside or not. So this getting rain or rainfall is an unobservable event. Okay? What is this security guard? What is unobservable event here is? Rainfall is unobservable event and umbrella is observable event. So, in this way, you can, by this security guard can assume that, okay, the rainfall is happening outside, okay? Because the manager, whenever he brings an umbrella. So, in this way, if I'll take this consideration, now what happens is that, for example, at time t, if whatever the unobservable states are there, we have taken an example of what? Rain and umbrella. So, unobservable event is rain. So, that rain can be represented by x suffix t and the observable evidence variable. It can be a single variable or it can be a set of evidence, observable evidence variable. So, whatever it is, but I'm representing the observable event as e. That means this xt is referred for umbrella. Sorry, unobservable, right? So, as unobservable means rainfall. So, xt stands for what? RT. Simply I can assume what? RT. XT means you can assume as RT. Why? Because rain is not observable by a security guard. He cannot see the rainfall is happening or not. But what he can observe is umbrella. So ET, that is observable event, is what? You can UT. U stands for umbrella, suffix T at time T. And this is x at time t, rs at time. Same time only, the both should happen. That's why we taken suffix t is equal to u suffix t. So in that sense. And you can have multiple set also. If you have multiple set, even then you can represent with the help of e and x, capital X and capital E. So in that way, we are taking here. So the same example which I just now said you, the same example is mentioned over here. What is that? The security guard is there, okay? And ET, what we have taken ET as umbrella, UT. And XT means what happens? RT. If ET is equal to UT and XT is equal to RT, that means what happens? If ET is true, if ET means what? If umbrella is true, that means if a manager brings an umbrella, or if E is equal to true, then X is also true. That means what he can assume, the security guard assumes that, outside there is a rainfall. So if ET is equal to true, then XT is also true. Or else E stands for what? UT. U means umbrella. If umbrella is there or if umbrella is brought by manager, then the security guard assumes that there is a rainfall outside. So in that sense, we are taking this That means this, the states, what we have taken, the states. What is that? Observable events, unobservable events. In that we have taken the value. And what we have observed, this is how we have observed. So observation can be done by some events which are observable events, which are non-observable events as well. Now, like that, there are much more examples here. So here what we are taking here, for example, if I'm taking diabetes monitoring, in order to monitor the level of blood sugar, a suitable interval might be an hour rather than a day. That's not I said you, right? 60 minutes I said you, right? So it depends on the example that which interval has to be chosen. For diabetes, I'm just taking an hour because it is suitable for that. But for other example, it is not like, for example, if I'm taking a rain which with consideration to a particular day, that today rainfall has happened. That means if I, the interval time, if I'm taking T1 as one day, Monday, so T2 will be Tuesday. So in that sense, the interval will be decided. But mostly for diabetes monitoring, we'll be considering an hour. Okay, so it depends on the example. So what happens here is that the main thing what I want to say in this slide is, according to this slide, is that state always starts at time zero. Why? Because initially there is no time has been completed. So initially the time is zero. Okay? But as soon as it you reaches at time T1, you will that means one time has been completed, not T is equal to zero. That's why you have to start with time is equal to zero, because initially you are starting T as zero. But when we are taking at time T0, like if I take umbrella world example, in umbrella world, what are the two variables, evidence and non-evidence variable? Okay, observable and non-observable variables. State variables are what? R0, R1, R2. Okay, that is rainfall, you can assume. And evidence variable, like how can you know that rainfall is happening? What is the evidence? The evidence is of umbrella. So U1, U2 or so on. That means for how many days? If you are taking for 5 days, a sample of 5 days. So the value of U1, U2, so on up to U5. Because the sample I'm taking for 5 days and the interval I'm taking as 1 day each. So that's why U1 stands for first day and U5 stands for fifth day. So in that way, we have to decide the evidence variable. And here, what is going to happen? For example, A is to B is what the sequence of integers. Okay, that means like the value of X. Okay, the value of X will going to be get changed, right? So, for example, if it is from XA to XB, so what we can denote, how can you denote the range of variable values, such as the first values to the last value, that is X of A is to B. Okay, in that way you can represent. And here, same thing. If this is an example, umbrella 1 is to 3 means for 3 days. The example which I said you is of 5 days. So what you can mention here, how can you mention? You can mention like this, U of 1 is to 5. Because you are taking evidence variable for 5 days. Okay, so in that one U1 to U5. So in that way will happens. But there are some problems practically if we will implement here. Because what happens is that if I'm taking a set of states, if I'm taking a set of evidence variables, set of states like we have taken just now in this example as R0, R1, R2. Okay, the set of states, state variables. Our evidence variable, what is the evidence variable we have taken? U1, U2. Like for 5 days, if I want to take, means U1 to U5. Okay? For a given problem. The next step is to specify how the world evolves. How the world evolves means how the next step will be calculated. How the transition happens. That's why it is called as transition model. What it is called as? Transition. Transition means moving from one state to another state. That means current state to the next step. Current step to the next step. So in that way, how the world evolves. So we have to describe the transition model. And also, we have to describe that how the evidence variable get their values. Evidence variable like U1, U2, U3, which we have taken just now, right? So how can you get the values of U1 to U5? So getting the values is performed by sensor models. So these two models will be used. Transition models means the how the state will going to be changed from current to next step. And sensor model means how this evidence variable will going to be get their values. Why? Because how means why I'm saying because the set of variables is unbounded. Unbounded means there is no limit. There is no upper limit or there is no lower limit. It can be, it includes many number of states without having any condition of boundedness. So as I, if for example, if I'm taking, like here, if it is for 5 days, let us assume that I have taken for 5 days, then it is well and good. Because I have given a restriction that you have to take for 5 days. Okay. But if I'm not given any restriction, then the sample will going to be get become very larger and larger. Because the set of variables, we haven't specified that it is to be bounded one. Okay. Generally, in general case that the set of variables will be unbounded. So as if now, because of this unboundedness nature, the state variables, that is like R0, R1, R2, are evidence variables such as U1, U2. What you have to take for every time slice? Okay? So you have to include all such kind of variables. And if I'm taking for a diabetic patient, let us assume if I'm taking for a diabetic patient, so if I'm taking an interval of 1 hour, so imagine for a 1 day, 24 hours will be there. So 24 slots of interval. That means 24 variables or 24 states has to specify the because the time slides of 1 hour. And if it is continuously monitoring without having any limit, so imagine how many number of state variables will be there and how many number of evidence variable there. This will be happen if the set of variables we've taken as in unbounded nature. If what we have taken in unbounded nature. So that's why it creates these two problems. What it creates, the first problem, as I said, as because it is unbounded in nature. So what happens is that if I want to find out the probability, conditional probability, okay, for particular event, okay, that means I have to consider CPT. What is that conditional probability table, which we have seen in Bayesian networks, that how this conditional probability table will be there. So for each time slice, and this CPT is not just not for a particular one day or 2 day. It will be for each time slice. Like for example, if I'm monitoring for sugar patient, so for a day, we require 24 hours, one hour if you are dividing. So 24 hours and there is no limit. So how many days and how many hours has to be taken here? So that becomes very hectic and it becomes, the sample becomes very large and it is increasing day by day. So for that purpose, there is one problem. If we taken in unbounded in nature. Second thing is that if I'm taking in unbounded nature, we have to involve the parents also, right? Okay, we have to involve the number of parents also, because day by day, what happened, the time in a day, time slices increases, the values will get going to be get change. The dependency get increases. So as if you know dependency increases, the number of parents will also get increases. What happens? Number of parents will also get increases. So because of that, you know, this problem will arise here. So because of these two problems, there is a solution for these two kind of problems. So the first problem which I said to you is about the unbounded nature. So we are using a process called as stationary process. So here what happens is that a process of change, whenever a change happens, will not, that is governed by laws. That means it governed by the rules. Okay, and it will not change over a period of time. Okay, that means limited. Like for example, if I'm taking the umbrella world example, you will get a clarity here. The conditional probability for umbrella is there. If I want to find out the conditional probability of umbrella, okay, I have to take the only the parents of UT. It's the same. That means this parent, okay, will be taken for all t. That means even if the t get changes, even if the t get changes, because if the time interval get changes, okay, even for that, the same value we are considering. Okay, so that's why what happens is that the reducedness will come over here. The problem of elongation or whenever it get going to be get expanded, it won't be expanded because you are taking the same value for all t, for all t, for all time interval. So this is one solution for the first problem. And the second problem solution is that, what is the second problem we have said, is that we require number of parents. What we require, as you know, unbounded means more number of parents will be there. So because of that, what happens, infinite number of parents will come. Okay, infinite number of parents means dependency will be more. So it is very difficult to calculate the conditional probability table. And because of that, it is very difficult to find out the joint probability, okay, for a particular event or a particular query. So because of that, they came up with the assumption called as Markov assumption. Markov assumption has been given by, okay, by a statistician called as Markov. So by this person, Markov has given this assumption. That's why the name has been given as Markov assumption. What this assumption will say is that, as we said that for a particular state, okay, we have an infinite number of parents will be there. But if I'm taking a current state, so that current state should, will not depend on the infinite number. It will just depends only on finite history of previous states. So because of that, what happens? The complexity get decreases. How? And finite number means how many states it will assume. That we have to see here. So for that, we have two process. That is first order and second order. For example, like here, if I'm taking the state here, this is my xt. So what first order will say is that I will assume only the parent which is associated with, that means directly associated with this xt. That means what it will be, xt minus 1. Okay, so it will just assume the single parent only. This is how the first order. Second order means it will assume two parents. Okay, it will assume last two parents. Like here, if xt is there and this is xt minus 1 and this is xt minus 2, for this event this is one parent and this is another parent. So two parents only it will consider in the second order, and first order only one parent will consider here. So that's why the simplest form is the first order. What it says, this behaves like a normal, you know, the procedure of Bayesian networks, in that we are taking only the one parent which is associated with that. And that is not exactly with that, but how similar with that one, that whenever a current state is there, current state just depends on the previous states, not on any earlier states. Okay. For example, if I'm taking P of xt, okay, such that a given, what is that, x of 0 to t minus 1, okay, these are what the parents, okay, what is, these are the parents. So for this one, what I'm considering only, t minus 1 only I'm considering, okay, 0 to t minus 1 means like x0, x1, x2, so on up to xt minus 1, and this is xt. So here, this xt will assume, will take the parent only the last one only, xt minus 1. It won't take all of this one. It won't take this one, and this one. Only the last one. Okay? But the second order, what it says, the second order will tell that xt, xt minus 1, and also xt minus 2. Okay, the last two previous states will be considered as the parent state of the state xt, current state. Okay, for that, if you see the diagram, you will come to know this is first order Markov process. Okay, for example, if I'm taking xt, xt is just depend on the previous state, that is xt minus 1, and xt minus 1 is just depend on the previous state xt minus 2. Whereas xt plus 2 is just depend on the previous state xt plus 1. And xt minus 2 is depend on whom? Xt minus 3. So like that it happens. But in the second order, this is my second order. In second order, what happens? For example, if I'm taking XT, now this XT is depend on XT minus 1. And also, what you can see this arrow, this also depends on XT minus 2. That means XT is depend on the last two previous states. Similarly, if I take XT plus 2, it's depend on XT plus 1. Also, it depends on XT. So in that way, this is second order and this is first order Markov process. So in that way, the problem will be going to be get solved by taking Markov assumption. Okay. So this is regarding the first part of the temporal model. The second part is inference. See, inference, I just said you the purpose. Inference means I know something, I want to find out something else from the given information. I know how the things has to perform, but I have to find out any extra other things from the given set of things. So for that purpose, there are four kinds of techniques which will be adopted in temporal model. The first one is filtering. You can also term them as monitoring. Second is predicting, smoothing, and most likely explanation. So first we will see what is filtering. Filtering, what filtering process is that it maintains the current state estimate and update it. For example, like, if I want to know the current situation of today, okay, like the probability of getting rain today or not, how can I know? I can know by the previous history of the information. For example, if I'm taking from the last 3 days, okay, from the last 3 days, so how I should take, for example, XT plus one is my fourth day. Okay, XT plus 1 today. For fourth day, I want to find out the probability of getting rainfall. So what I'm considering? I'm considering the last 3 days. So last 3 days means here, what I'm finding is P of X4, P of 1 to 4. Okay, with respect to the evidence from 1 to 4. And this filtering of, I'm performing filtering of, E4 means the current state with respect to what? With respect to XT means, with respect to X3 means X3 is from the last 3 days with considering the evidence from 1 to 3. From the last 3 days, it takes the history, it takes the information and it will update the current value of X4. Okay, so in that way, you are going to perform filtering process. Simply, if you refer the second point, you'll come to know that it needs to go back over the entire history of percepts for each update so that to know the current state. We are stating the current state, estimating the current state. So current state is X4. So we are estimating by taking the sample from 1 to 3. Okay. So, and remember, this 1 to 3 should be in arranged order, like E1, E2, E3. Okay, it should be in arrange order, because by this arrange order only we'll come to know the pattern of the current situation. So that's why the last point, if you will come to know that, you have to keep track of the current state and it needs to be in order. This thing should need, you should not take like E3 or E1, E2. So you will not get a logical conclusion. You will get only if you'll take in a sequence of values, such as A1, E1, E2, E3. So in that sense, what happens? You can decide rationally, means logically, you can, the decisions can be made. Okay? Here, we can decide means like here, the software will decide, because like artificial intelligence is also a rational agent. So rationally also, it will think logically. So in order to make the AI-based application to think in a rational way, we have to put in order to get the actual information of the current state. So this is regarding filtering process. So the next process is predicting. So the predicting means here, you have to compute the posterior distribution over the future state. That means you have to take, you have to estimate the future state. That means generally prediction, you may say. Prediction means estimating the future state. What will happen tomorrow or what will happen after some days. So how can you estimate? You can estimate by the current value and from the last 3 days or from last the history. For example, like here, umbrella, same umbrella example we are taking here. If I want to compute the probability of rain 3 days from now, Okay. 3 days from now, given that I have to take, what I have to take? I have to take all the values, the previous information. So the previous information, so 3 days. Okay. What I have to take? K value, because I have taken 3. I have said 3 days, right? So K I have taken, assume as 3. And this K always, it should be greater than 0. Then only it will be valid. Okay. So you have to estimate the number of days or the number of time amount, time period. So if I'll take T here, so T plus 3. So what it will be? T plus 3 given A of 1 to T. Okay. So we are finding out for the value for T plus 3. Okay. What happened? The probability, computing the probability of rain 3 days from now. Okay. 3 days from now means from this day, what will be happen after 3 days? Okay, for that purpose, we have to use this prediction process. So we are estimating by using the existing information only. Existing information means till current information, T, 1 to T, previous record, okay? 1 to T, by taking the, with the help of the evidence from 1 to T, we are estimating that after 3 days, what will happen? Whether the rainfall will happen or not. So that's why this should be greater than 0. Okay? So in that way, the predicting a prediction works here. Now, what is the second, third thing is about the smoothing process. So smoothing process here is that your the process of computing the distribution over the past states up to the present state. That means previous data plus current data. Both has to be considered. Like if I take this same example, umbrella example, you are computing the probability that it rained last Thursday. Last Thursday means previous data. So based on that, what you have to give an observation that whether we need to take umbrella today or not, whether there is a chance of rainfall or not. How can you take? By taking the previous example. So that's why you can observe here the K value is between 0 and T. Okay? The K value is in between 0 and T. Okay? So now this K value, T can be anything, right? So this T is what the time period. Based on the time period we are taking here. So X, so probability of XK, which will be in between 0 and T, will be taken here given what? The evidence from 1 is to T. That means this is a time slot. Is to T means the range. What is this? A range of values. So in that way, the smoothing works here. Now finally, the most likely explanation. Fourth one is most likely explanation. You will get to know what is that. Here, for example, from last 3 days. Okay, like if you consider last 5 days. If I'm taking the data of last 5 days, okay, what happens is that from the last 3 days, that means from first to three, okay, what happens? The rainfall is happening, okay, the rainfall is occurring, and fifth day also there is a rainfall. Okay, what happens here is that if you see the example, if the umbrella appears on each of the first 3 days, each from the 5 days, and is absent on the fourth day. Umbrella is not present on fourth day. But umbrella is present on first day, second day, third day. And umbrella is also present on fifth day. But umbrella is absent. That means umbrella has not brought by the person on fourth day. So what we are going to find out, is it because of the problem? That means the person has forgotten to bring umbrella? Or is it because the rainfall has not happened? So what you can get the data, if you observe the kind of data, here from first to three, that means from last first 3 days, rainfall is happening. Fifth day also, the rainfall is happening. So fourth day, what is that here is that, the director here has forgotten to bring the umbrella. Okay? Because the rainfall will be in continuous pattern. Okay? It won't be something like 3 days happening, then what happened? Fourth day it won't happen, fifth day it happened. It can happen, but the most likely explanation. What is the term we are using here as? Most likely explanation of that. That means the more probability of, or the most likely explanation is that on the fourth day, what happens? The director has forgotten to bring the umbrella. So that is the thing here. So it depends on the kind of data. That's why we taken these examples. Okay. So the question is that whether the umbrella has been forgotten by director or there was no rainfall on fourth day. We need to estimate that one. So how can you estimate? You can estimate by most likely explanation that the director has forgotten to bring the umbrella. That is only the most likely explanation for the given problem. Okay. So this is how we are inferring. That means we are getting the information from the existing set of information. So this is regarding the inference in temporal model. Okay. So what we have covered in temporal model, we have seen why we require temporal model by taking an example of static world and by taking an example of dynamic world. In dynamic world, we require temporal model, and in temporal model, we have seen that how the states are how can you provide the observations, how can you provide the observation values and state values. All of this we have discussed. Okay. Also, we have discussed the problem. The problem has been solved by stationary process as well as Markov assumption, along with inference in temporal model. So with this, I have completed the session. Thank you.